as always, congratulations to Valmiera. Good win. Very intensive game. We knew that they will invite us for this end-to-end transition game. And our problem today was, after very good first 20 minutes, we were able to control the ball. Then the game became so much space after Valmiera attack. We had a chance to attack, things like that, when we were winning 1-0. And these moments, we have two options. Kill the game, score a second, score a third goal. We did not do it. And then, of course, when it comes to this basketball game, Valmiera is very effective, you know, with very dangerous players up there. And in the end, logical what happened in a football, they scored two goals. And first goal to give away, I asked the players, we knew it, where the space will be, so Valmiera pressing with the diamond, we missed one pass of the building up, that can happen. And then the second goal, second phase of the set piece, we could not score our set pieces, the ball was there, you know, we could not get that one shot, you know, even more clear situations. So, but that's football, and as I said it, in the end, Valmiera did enough these small things to deserve the 3 points. And as I said, it disappointment for us, but a little bit, you know, easy to understand when you saw the game that we cannot push our luck, you know, this much. You know, we need to do better football actions.
Jā, nu kā vienmēr šādās situācijās apsveicam pretiniekus, labu uzvaru viņiem, šī bija intensīva spēle, zinājām, ka viņi mums piedāvās spēli uz abām pusēm, un pēc labām pirmajām 20 minūtēm bija ļoti daudz brīvo zonu, un šādā situācijā bija divas iespējas, vai nu mēs iesitam otros un trešos vārtus, to mēs nespējām izdarīt, un attiecīgi šādā tādā, nu, kaut kādā ziņā basketbola spēlē Valmiera ir ļoti spēcīga, ir atbilstoši spēlētāji un sanāca tā, ka viņi iesit šos divus vārtus un pirmajos vārtos, nu, zinājām, ka var gadīties šīs kļūdas izejā no savas aizsardzības puses un otrajos vārtos nespējām izsist bumbu un Valmiera kopumā izdarīja pietiekami, lai šajā dienā nopelnītu 3 punktus. Ir vilšanās, bet mums ir jāspēlē labāk.
If we speak about the start of the second half, Valmiera pushed hard even after the first goal. So what happened? It was about some psychology or it's Valmiera changes?
No, as you see, even now in the end, it's a football logic. We are one player short, you can put the pressure, you know, and that's, I try to explain it, you know, my first answer, that we could not control the game anymore. We could not hold enough time with the ball to make Valmiera run back. So we attack it so fast some moments, and then we could not finish our last chance. And Valmiera's strikers were still walking back, and then they were able to get the ball, you know, and attack again, and then it comes, you know, the energy for them. And start of the second half, we knew it as a start of the match that they will come very, very hard. And as I said it, we were not today good enough, you know, to handle these two moments.
After second goal, Valmiera second goal, you put experienced guy Miloš Jojić, who can control the game. Probably, can you say what happened with him? How he's ready to play after the injury?
Yeah, I think what you saw today, how Miloš Jojić, how he came in. He came in to change the game. And you see, you know, his level, you see his determination, attitude, you know, to come and, you know, change the game. And I'm very happy to get him back, because as you said, he's a very experienced player, quality player, important player for us. And it has been a little bit difficult pre-season for him, you know, little injuries, some moments, you know, has not yet got, you know, the level, you know, what we know where he is. But I think today, and already talking with him yesterday, I saw he's approaching his level, you know, so good to get him back.
Other decision in starting 11, Muzinga, Lodinganda as midfield. How can you explain this decision?
I think, you know, we have really missed Muzinga, you know, he missed pretty much whole pre-season, you know, with the injury. And we know Musinga. For me, he can play every position on the football field. He's very, very clever football player. And of course, he has this technical ability. He has this game vision, and he has this intensity to defend and progress the ball, you know. So for him to come first game for first 90 minutes of this year, so it was not easy, but how he handled it, you know, it was very, very happy with that.
But again, why this position, not as a right back, but, as you played before?
Yeah, he played right back, he played left back, but I still get back, you know, this we needed the control. And we had this control, you know, with Babets and Milos, you know, Babets and Musinga controlled the game, have these two sixes, you know, to be outlet, have a winger out wide, you know, keep the width for us, you know, and it worked very well. And then, of course, it worked very well, you know, the start of the game. And then, of course, we have this, knowing Valmiera, you know, they quickly and deadly transitions, you know, when they defend, we needed those two sixes to play there. And it was choice for this match. Will he play there for next match? We need to see. Will he go back to play left wing or right back? It's opponent little bit dictates, you know, that this.
To continue this basketball topic, was this related to the risky football from Valmiera? That they, as you said, forwards left in the, your side of the pitch, and also this pressing, and also maybe small stadium, fast throw-ins, this also was the important
thing? Yeah, and that's I said it, you know, Valmiera deserve it to win this football match, because they really do this very well. And it's not only the small field. Last game, they were big field RFS, and they did the same. Even they had even more space to run, so I think it's more difficult to play the small field for them, you know, this transition football, but they do it very well. The players are very determined, you know, to do these things. And we knew it, what we needed to do it. And today we were not just good enough, you know, these two moments, you know, to stop them.
A crucial moment in this game was the first conceded goal for you. As I remember, Kirill Siljans made this parallel pass in his own side of the pitch. Do you see this as a crucial mistake, or maybe
No. As I said it, you know, no. Sorry to disturb you. I asked him to make this pass because we have been want to build up, you know, in a good way, you know, there, and then he just a little bit under hit the ball. The player was free there because the characteristics how Valmiera wanted to press us, you know, the one side, can we get quickly other side and then attack them, we did not manage, but still we had a maybe, you know, chance to stop, you know, what happened after that. But that happens in football. We're gonna lose some balls and we're gonna lose some matches. Now we lost this match, so now the most important thing is next game is coming Thursday, and it's important that we because I don't know, okay, we miss Bashir through the red card. I don't know what's happening with Baba, you know, with his shoulder yet. Is there some other things? So the most important thing, we learn from this game, and then we need to be ready for the Thursday. And that's the beauty of this Virs League, you know, so many games coming, and I can see the eyes of the players, you know, to what today meant them, you know. They are, of course, very, very disappointed, but at the same time, they are very honest boys. They are very honest players. They know at the same time as well that we could not do these crucial moments. We could not do them today good enough. And then against any team, you know, they can punish you. And it happened today.
Frank Maher, Latvian Football Podcast. You had 42% possession today. The Valmiera midfield also seemed to be pulling all the strings, winning the ball and holding possession. Do you feel they just wanted it more than your team, and were they a little bit more motivated than you guys today?
No. Football would be too easy if it's who wants more. And of course, our players, they wanted the more. But I think you answered your question with those numbers. That was our problem today, that we could not control the ball, which is our strength. We could not control. We made too many these. We got a good position. We had a chance to attack. We had a chance to connect the pass. We could not connect that pass. And then Valmiera get the ball and they can attack, because as I said, it, they are quality players. And that was the big problem was we could not, even this so-called difficult small field, we could not control the ball enough. and that why it came, you know, the pressure came, you know, too much on us, and it's pretty logic what happened then.
Did you anticipate Valmo would play these tactics today compared to their farm counter-attacking game?
Yes. That was as ever, you know, it was as clear as possible, and that's what I like, you know, when the team has clear identity what they try to do it, and they do it very, very well, and I'm a little bit repeating myself. We knew exactly what they're going to do it, and these games, you just need to talk them. Is it easy? No. But then there is a moment. It's not all about these defending actions when they go it. It's more what we do when we have a ball. Can we hold long enough with the ball that you take the energy out of the opponent?
Yeah, quick final question. What was your take on the red card today? Especially with VAR and how long it took.
I have not seen it. I need to see it. You see it. What do you think? It was a crunch tackle, maybe. That's why I'm very honest. I have not seen. I only see, you know, the live, and of course, taking so much time, referee, you know, to watch in the VAR, VAR, then as always, we take it, you know, and we move on.
I have a question about defensive line. First question about Kirill's Ilinch. He will be your first choice in defensive line in this season because he started this Virsliga season in the first 11, and he played the third match today in first 11.
Yeah, and for Kirill, actually he's already experienced players. He has many Virsliga games already, and this is only accumulation from the preseason. He had a very, very strong preseason. He played center back, he played left back, and he's deserving to take his position in a starting lineup. Will he be there? No one knows, you know. That's because that's how we work, you know. Now this game is gone, we move towards the next game, but he has been very, very solid all these months that we have been together, and he has played some difficult games. He's very good with his left foot. Like today, he excellent assist for our goal. So it's too much now. We go to Kirill to lose one ball, you know, with the build-up. No. That will happen for every player.
Mm-hmm. He's better as center back or left back, or maybe he's strong both positions.
Yeah, I think that's the little bit, you know. For me, I like him a lot as a center back. He's not the strongest and tallest, but he's very football strong, that he can anticipate the things. As a left back, maybe he can use his qualities of cross the ball, because that's a very good quality what he has, and he can play with the three center backs, play this outside center back, you know. So it's a richness to our team that, you know, we have a player who can play many positions. I see it this way.
Mm-hmm. And the last question: when Antonis Chernomordis will be ready to play?
Good question. And our captain, and I think tomorrow he will start the training with the team. When he will be ready, Let's hope soon, you know, so then we are stronger team.
Not question about football, but today, holiday for everybody, a lot of people in stands, a lot of people around the fans. How big was atmosphere on bench? What did you feel the energy was around it?
Yes, it was very good, and big thank you for our fans, Riga FC fans. They made a lot of noise, you know, behind our bench, and they were supporting us until the end. And this is football, and I'm happy it's coming, you know, now to Virsliga as well, because in here it's a quality teams, quality players, good interesting football as well. So it felt good football match.
Valmiera fans traditionally chooses one target man from opposition team to make trash talk, and today they chose Edward Daškevič. Did you feel this, that he maybe is too emotional? And
no, actually, I think, you know, yeah, we were talking before the match. I think last time it was maybe Jurkovic or something, you know. So but I think Edu enjoyed it. And with his first half performance, how dangerous he was there, you know, I think he just got more energy out of it. And of course, need to remember, boys, all these national team players, they have been away with the national team, just training, one, two trainings with us. So it was not easy to come, you know, and play, you know. But I think all the football players, if you ask, they enjoy this moment and they bring energy to them, because it's a part of the football that opponent fans, you know, give you the stick, try to support, and it's all around the world. And if you ask anyone, they say yes, any day, give us, you know. And as little bit, you know, the previous question, it was good carnival feeling, you know, on the stadium. And of course, yeah, it was, as I said, it felt proper football match.
About Luis Verico absence, What is the reason?
Little something on his leg, and in as well with him in this match, you know, it was a pity to miss him, but that's football, you know. We had, you know, very strong team today, and good news are that he will be back very soon, I hope, you know, so again we get players more and more back.
And continue about Luis Verico. You chose him as a captain while Antonis Černomordis wasn't in the team ready to play. What was the reason? Because there are some guys who are longer in the team, some Latvian guys, Matrevits, for example.
Yes. And but then at the same time, you know, we were talking why Kira is playing, you know, this, you know, Iberico earned this respect from his teammates, from his from the coaching staff, putting everything for the team. He needed to play some different positions. He put everything for the team, and that tells me he's a captain materiality, that he puts, you know, the team before, you know, himself. Of course, he would like to play a striker and score a goal, but we needed him the midfield. We needed him to play in the winger. He was there, and I said, you know, our players, they are very honest, and they are good guys. They are hurting now. They are hurting. Their pride, their football pride, is hurting. And only thing they are waiting, you know, to get next game and start playing.
Another Spanish-speaking player, Brian Peña. Last season we saw him as a sparkle in some matches, but now we see him in Riga 2 squad. Why so?
Riga 2 squad. Ah, okay. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Yeah. But I saw this sparkle, you know, last week on our training, so the sparkle is coming back, so wait a little moment.
Do you know what your starting 11 is this season? Seems to be like chopping and changing, similar to last season.
Yes, and it's an interesting topic, because that's our strength. We can change a lot of things depending the opponent, depending the way we want to play. But at the same time, these moments when you start picking our starting lineup, it's very, very difficult moments, because why I need to leave him out and put him in, why I could play him, and this comes the next thing. And we have been talking a lot with the players. It needs to be our strength. That the players, yes, who are on the bench, of course they are disappointed, they are hurted, but if and when we are successful, everyone, the players, not even in the squad, players on the bench, they need to push for one direction for this moment. Then when the match is finito, we go back home, then we can discuss, then we can see what we can do better. But for this moment, we all push same direction. Is it easy for the players? No. Do we have done it? Yes, we have been doing it. We need to do it. So I'm very, very happy how the players do it.
So you've made a decision to adapt a rotation system within the squad.
Yeah, and it's a little bit, as I said, it's a rotation, it's an opponent, it's a little bit, you know, the injuries. Of course, so many games coming up now, so we need to use this rotation as our strength. as our strength. And of course, there will be some games we keep, you know, same starting lineup. There will be some games we need to chop and change. But that's, again, we think about game by game. So it's not like, okay, I rotate now all season. I don't know. Next game, let's see what's happening.
Do you think Riga has a problem with the attack? Because we have a third match when Riga scored only one goal.
Yeah.
What is the reason that Riga scored only one goal per match? Also, you have a lot of chances to score.
Yes, we have a lot of chances to score. And I put it this way, it's all about the mathematics. We have a lot of chances to score. The goals will come. We just need to do a little bit with a better quality, a little bit with a more calmer head, these final moments, and the goals start coming. Goals start. We are not there yet. We're rushing some things, you know, inside the box. Or then we're taking too much time because we want to be so sure that we finish this action. Instead of playing with the instincts, and then when the ball comes, finish the action, 2-3-0, game finished.
Pirmkārt, visiem priecīgas svētkus, gan tie, kas pie televizoriem bija, gan tie, kas stadionā, it sevišķi tiem, kas stadionā, viņi bija fantastiski. Jūs esat fantastiski, ne tikai Valmieris, bet arī Rīgas fani. Kā jau pirms spēles čaļiem teica, laukā būs balīt. Un ejam izbaudam balīt un cerams, kā laimīgām beigām, nevis laimīgām, ar labām beigām. Un kāds tad ir balītē labs veiks, ka tu aizved meiteni mājās. Un tad mēs šodien aizvedām to meiteni mājās un prieks, ka lieldienās mums izdevās izcīnīt 3 punktus.
Par pašu spēli pastāst vairāk. Pirmais puslaiks 0-1, otrais puslaiks uzvarēts. Kas mainījās, kā attīstījās?
Nu, principā nervoza sākām mazliet bīgi izskatījās, bija mazliet sasteigtas darbības, bet tas ir tikai normāli, jo zinām, kāds pie mums te Valmierā, tomēr tas segums ir, nav no tiem labākiem un bija, teiksim tā, gaidīja no Rīgas mazliet agresīvāka presinga, lai gan viņi presingoja, viņi centās, bet ja tur runājam puslaikā, visu parādījām, kā uzlaust, kā aiziet ārā, jau puslaikā, pirmā puslaika beigās, principā mums tas izdevās. Paņemām bumzi un kontroli, tad otrā puslaikā vēlreiz apstiprinājām, parādījām, izrunājām, un es domāju, ka jau Rīgas presings beidzās. Un pēc 2-1, protams, Rīga mēģināja atspēlēties, kaut kāda centiena bija, bet es domāju, ka mēs labi viņam tikām galā, un neko draudīgu un bīstamu viņam mums nesagādāja arī atrodoties iecenējos.
Kolēģis sacīja, ka ja būtu izdevies Riga gūt otros vārds pirmajā puslaikā, tad spēle būtu nogalināta, vai tu piekrīti, ka pie 0-2 viss būtu beidzies?
Grūti man tev pateikt. Pirmam kārtām, ja Džips būtu uzreiz pēc goliesi, tas būtu viss 1-1 un līdz otriem vārtiem pat nebūtu aizsapņojušies, tad es tā varu atbildēt tev. Tāpēc, kā būtu, ja būtu, tas ir jautājums. Nav, kā bija, tā bija. No, viņi neguva otros vārds un mēs guvām divus vārdus.
Malojo aizsargi izvēles, tas pašas, kas pret RFS, bet otrajā puslaikā Maksims Toņišovs atpakaļ, Emils Birka pastāst, cik daudz domāja varbūt pirms spēles, kā rīkoties tieši šajās pozīcijās?
Es zināju, ka principā būtu jāspēlē Birkam šo spēli, bet kā tu saku, mums bišķi, kā es saku, mums bišķi jāpauklējas ar Juku arī šādās spēlēs, ja mēs gribam, lai viņš progresētu, lai viņš augtu sevišķi aizsardzības darbībās, un arī viņam ir tas, teiksim tā, tas pirmo spēļu sindroms, viņš ir satraucies, viņš nav tik brīvs, viņš nav tik kreatīvs, kā mēs gribētos. Un tā mēs šādās spēlēs viņam dodam to iespēju spēlēt, dodam to iespēju, lai viņš atvērtos sezonas gaitā, jo mēs zinām, uz ko viņš ir spējīgs, redzējām treniņu nometnē. Emils izgāja atkal, izdarīja visu to darbu, ko Juks nepareiz darīja. Principā Rīgai veidojas momenti tikai tādēļ, ka pozicionāli gan Dusalījevs, gan Juks netika galā ar saviem pienākumiem. Neteikšu darbībā uz 1-1, ja Dusalījevs vairāk 1-1, Daškevičs, viņi tur bišķi pavazāja, teiksim, tā tad Juks lidoja ārā, pameta savas zonas, vaig vai nevaig, un tā Emīlam tās ir ļoti spēcīgas darbības. Viņš zina, kad iziet, kad iesaisties, kad piebremzēt, un līdz ar to tas bija. Man liekas, ka ļoti labas mājiņas abas divas, un arī Toņiševs, nezinājām, kāds viņš būs pēc traumas, bet arī Maksims tomēr ir mazliet agresīvāks, un, ja redzētu, otrā puslaikā neļauj vispār Daškevičam izvērsties, uzreiz bija klāt, uzreiz bija kontakts, un tas principā arī piebrumzēja viņu centienus kaut ko veidot caur kreiso malu.
Un, ja pirmajā puslaikā neiešāvās doma, ka varētu veikt ātrās maiņas pa 0-1 rezultātu, tad Daškevičs kārtu reiz apspēlē vai man kādā ieskrien?
Nu, principā nē, tāpēc, ka es redzēju, kā virzās spēlē. Principā jā, mēs ielaidām nevajadzīgs muļķīgs vārtus, ļoti žēl par to, bet principā pēc tam Rīga uzreiz arī nostādījumi no trenera nosēžamies, atdodam bumbu, vai tā bija tā. Tā vai nē, es nezinu, bet es redzēju, ka mēs bumbu paņēmām zem kontroles un Rīgā ļoti daudz zondā. Būsim godīgi, viņiem Daškevičs nav spēcīgākais aizsardzības darbībās, Muzingā balsta zonā nav spēcīgākais aizsardzības darbībās, un līdz ar to tad Dusalieviem tur bija daudz, kur izplisties pirmā puslaika, to arī mēģinājām izmantot to malu, un līdz ar to bumba. Es jūtu, ka spēle līdz puslaikam ir jānovelk, tomēr tās ir, jo ja tu uztais pirmā puslaikā maiņu, tu zaudē to reizi otrā puslaikā, un spēle bija ļoti līdzīga, un tās reizes tieši, kuras tev paliek trīs, ir vajadzīgs, lai labi novadītu spēli līdz galam.
Muzingu gaidīja, pārsteidz tev, ka viņš bija vidū?
Man pārsteidza, jā, jo ieraugot sākumu sastāvu, katrā ziņā man sliecās uz 3-4-3. Sēmu, un es gribēju saprast, kādēļ 3-4-3, un pētīju, kad viņi ir spēlējuši pirmsezonā vienreiz tā, bet un pagājušajā gadā Auda arī 2-3 spēles bija spēlējuši Valakā arī. Un jo man bija doma, varbūt viņi pakārtojas mums divu uzbrucējiem, un mēs jau arī izstāstījām uzreiz ģērbtuvē, ja viņi gadījumā spēlē 3-4-3, kā mēs kustamies, kā mēs darām, bet koncentrējāmies tomēr uz 4-2-3-1, tā kā viņi spēlē iepriekšējās spēles, un tāpēc tas ko būtiski nemainīja, bijām gatavi arī, ja būs savādāk, bet Muzinga balstā interesants lēmums. Es domāju, ka Muzinga ir labs spēlētājs, kvalitīvs, viņš var spēlēt daudzās pozīcijās, bet slinks spēlētājs.
Jo maču laikā varēja manīt un neviltot prieku par tām situācijām, kad jau atrodoties jūs vadībā, nevis vienkārši risinājumi ar tālu piespēli izsist kaut kur bumbu, bet kad diezgan augstasnīgi uz riska robežas caur vārtsargu, caur centra aizsargiem izspēlēt. Tā ir tā lieta, ko gribējās jau pagājušā gadā labākā kvalitātē redzēt, un tagad tu redzi, ka tas augsts nāk.
Jā, jo mēs par to arī runājam pret RFS spēles, ja pamanījāt, pirmā puslaikā mēs tāpatās sākām, mēģinājām, divreiz izgājām, trešo reizi maza kļūdiņa bija pārķēra, ceturto atkal pārķēra, un mēs sabijāmies, un sākām spēlēt daudz vienkāršāk, bet tas, ko mēs gribam tā spēlēt, mēs gribam iedot pārliecību, protams, iespējams kaut kur būs kļūdas, bet kurš nekļūdās, visi kļūdās jebkādās situācijās. Mēs mēģinām to, un ja sanāk, protams, dubult prieks, bet ir spēles nogriežiņi, spēlētājs, tu zini, kuros mēs to nedaram un kuros mēs to daram, kuros mēs varam atļauties tā spēlēt, kuros mēs nevaram atļauties tā spēlēt.
Un, Jurģi, vēl viens vissvarīgākais jautājums, kādus es mēdzu uzdot. Vai tev nebija balta skaudība par to līdzutēju, kurš kublā varēja vērot spēli?
Es viņu ieraudzīju sākumā, sēžot, vērojot. Nu, iesildīšanos, bet tur jau man liekas Kareļins, jā, bija viņš spēlē. Jā, Kareļins jau bija piegājis klāt, un saprot, ka tā man vietiņa nesanāks aizņemt, un tāpēc, diemžēl.
Frank Maher, Latvian Football Podcast. Great performance today, really impressive game, but the goal was a defensive communication goalkeeper error. Does defensive communication and also the goalkeeper being overly reliant on punching the ball worry you at all?
Yeah, I was talking with Carlos. Do I need to answer English? Yeah. I was talking with Carlos and Duke about it, and as Carlos answered me, he said to the Duke that you go and push him and play the ball. And Duke, at this moment, was understanding that I'm playing. And at the end, you see the Everton goal yesterday? Same, yeah, the 1-1 draw, the last goal was the same. The ball bounces, no one catches it, goes into the net. It was like, it's communication. It's a lot of communication, but as we know, defender, if you can play the ball, you must play the ball, and only then it's keeper.
He was a bit error-prone last season. How are you ensuring that doesn't happen again in terms of communication and punching and things like that?
It won't happen because he's second year here. Of course, at the beginning of the game, there was two situations. I think there where he can easily catch the ball and start to play, but he was punching, yeah, as you said. But he's young guy. We don't need to forget that. Yeah, he's still young. He will still get more experience. Yeah, and I think at the end, Carlos will be a very good keeper.
Your starting three midfielders are some of the most technically talented in the league, and their work rate was incredible today. How have you managed to find the right blend with the three, particularly after the challenges of last season?
Yeah, you know, we were thinking about the tactics last year when we understand that it won't be the best year for us. We started to think about this season then. Yeah, of course, we are really happy that Wapne are in our team. And we were talking a lot with him because we were thinking about that Wapne is a little bit lazy sometimes, but he's growing. He's growing. He understands that football is not only with the ball and a lot of hard work without the ball. And he grows like, and he's much stronger in that. And I think Gustavo still, I'm not satisfied still with him. Yeah, he wants to play only with the ball. Yeah, and a lot of Brazilians, we have a new Brazilian player also in the team who arrived here. And, you know, this mindset is like, I'm from Brazil, I'm in Latvia. Yeah, what I would go and play, enjoying. No, there is a difficult championship. You need to adapt and you need to fight. It's Baltic states like that. Yeah. But it was four. I think Jeep also we play more like the number 10 in Jibulgay. And I think that's the best position for him. That's the best position. And if we want to use our best players on the field all together, we must find the tactic that works for us.
Vai Kristers Aleksejčiks ir labākais spēlētājs, Valmieras spēlētājs par pēdējās minūtes, jo viņš bija pēdējās minūtes pret RFS, un šodien viņš bija pēdējās minūtes spēlē pret Riga FC. Vai viņš ir labi par mierīgi spēlē no pēdējās minūtes?
Es domāju, ka Kristeram ir viss, lai viņš spēlētu arī no pirmajām minūtēm, un mums visi spēlētāji gribam, lai spēlē arī pēdējās minūtes, bet gan pret RFS, gan šodien spēle prasīja, ka mums vajag pastiprināt mazliet masu laukuma vidu, to, teiksim tā, gaisu arī uz pēdējām minūtēm, standartiem un vispārējais, lai arī bijām vairākumā, lai arī nonācām vairākumā, zinājām, ka Rīga mēģinās spiest un mācamies no kļūdām, nelidojam pa galu, pa kaklu skriešu, lai gūtu trešos vārds, kaut kādā iespēja bija arī pielikt punktu jau pie rezultāta 2-1. Tad Aleksejčiks ir tas spēlētājs, kurš var, ja vajag, kādam kārtīgi iedot iekšās un arī visu gaisu vinēt.
Cik lietderīgs un noderīgs viņam pašiem, komandai, bija brauciens uz Kipru, Renāram un Maksimam?
Maksam? Pag vēlreiz.
Tonišovs.
Jā. Cik viņiem noderīgs bija? Jā, es domāju, ka Maksam, patiesībā Maksam bija ļoti noderīgs, jo viņš tur izveseļojās, paldies medicīnas blokam, kas tur strādā, protams, bet nu, iepazinās, es domāju, ar to, kā viss notiks izlasē, kā notika iekšienē. Renārs, tas pats ļoti žāl, ka viņš ir izkrits vēl 3 nedēļas vismaz ārā un nebūs atpakaļ, mazliet neveiksmīgi viņam tā situācija, es domāju, tur gan sagumi, gan mazliet pāreiz no zaļā uz dabīgo un viņam... Līdz ar to arī mazliet tas jutās un Balodim, es domāju, manā skatījumā viss neefektīgākais tas brauciens bija, lai arī viņš nospēlēja 45 minūtes, tad no Balojas gaidīja vairāk minūtes tur, bet redzam, ka tas viņam iedeva sākumā to mazliet satraukumu, bija dažas kļūdes, bet iespēlējās, un es skatos, kā kal parādīja, kad ir labākais aizsargs Latvijas čempionātā, virslīgā viennozīmīgi, un tur man var vai iesist vai atņemt, es viennozīmīgi to atzīstu, ka šobrīd labākais centra aizsargs Latvijas virslīgā ir Daniels Balods.
Varbūt arī redzēt, kas notika ar Renāru, jo no izlases puses šķiet, ka nebija tur komunikācijas.
Jā, nu viņam sākumā likās, ka tas ir spazms ikram muskuls, bet viņš tā kā viņš man pats stāstīja, ka viņš nosildējas lejā, iesildīšanās laikā, skrienot nosildējas lejā, un tad man bija tāda maza saruna ar medu personālu izlases, kuru es viņam centos, teiksim tā, pierādīt, nepierādīt, es vienkārši paprasīju, vai viņu var uztaisīt, Pārbaudus, ko es dabūju atbildēt, mums tā pārbauda neko nemainīs mūsu ārstēšanas, teiksim tā ārstēšanas process, kā mēs to darīsim, uz ko es centos pateikt, jā, bet pie tām dienām viņš atgriežas pie mums, un mums ir vajadzīgs tas nozīmējums, tā diagnoze, kas tad tur ir noticis, bet labi, un tā arī nonācam, ka viņi netaisa, jo tur esot spazms, un nākamā dienā Renārs sajūties labāk, un jau kustoties, un viss ir kārtībā, un uz ko es atbildēju, ka es Renāru ļoti labi pazīstu. pareizi, viņa uztaisīja operāciju gadu atpakaļ, viņš nākamā dienā teica, oh, es baigi labi jūtos, es jau varētu tagad iet laukumā. Un līdz ar to, protams, mēs arī no savas puses jau pieteicām pārbaudi. Protams, pēc trijām dienām, tas, ko es gribu teikt, es centos izskaidrot, ka, ja man spēlētājs stāsta, ka viņam muskulis ir nošļūtis, ka viņš ir to pamanījis, nu, tur nevar būt nekādas pazumas, sitiet man nost, tas nav iespējams. Ja, nu, ja protams, tas trenārs pats pēc sajūtām viss pareizi stāsta, nu, tad jā, tomēr mēģināja viņš tur trenēties un treņā sajūt, kad viss tad arī izlas uztaisīja, izmeklējumu uztaisīja diagnostu, tas pēc tam sakrita mūsējo, jā, un Renāram tur ir. Mas, teiksim, tā ne plīsums, bet nezinu, kā tas ārstniecīgs saucās, tad, kad man mūsu fizio pasaka to slēdzienu vai atsūtu, un tad es vienmēr prasu, un tagad lūdzu, nu, normālam cilvēkam latviskiem vārdiem pasakstu, kas tas tāds ir.
Jums arī bija brauciens uz Poliju, uz Gdaņsku pastāstīja. Kas tur notika, kā Valmiera var zaudēt 1-5?
Pārbaudījām visi spēlētājs, visiem ļāvām izspēlēties, pirmām kārtām pārēju uz zaļo laukumu, laukums bija mīgs, pirmā puslaikā uzskatu, ka bijām labā komanda laukumā, un otrajā, protams, pēc maiņām, pēc visu, redzējāt, uzspēlē pilnīgi viss, jaunais Cepeļovs nospēlē visu 90 minūtes pa centra aizsargu, labu izspēlēties, tur rezultātam nebija nozīmes, un protams, es uzskatu, ka tas rezultāts vispār neatbilst spēles gaitai kā tādai, nu, ja mēs paskatāmies, ka to pēc tam statistikas, gan sitiens, gan visu, nu, alidoja visu sasit, ko viņi varēja no mūsu kļūdām, paši atvedām pusgols, protams, es saku, laukums pārēja uz zaļā laukumu, kur mēs laik te trenējamies uz mākslīgā, bet, nu, mēs doma mums bija tāda, kāpēc mēs to darījām, lai daudziem jauniem spēlētājiem tādu iedot kāda eiro, paostīt tā kā tāda eiro kausu sajūtiņu, ka tu aizlido pirms spēles dienā, patrenējies, mēs gan patrenējamies spēles dienā, un nospēlē pēc tam un lido mājās, un es uzskatu, kad ja tas būs iespējams finansiāli un viss, ka tas ir jādara mums katru reizi ne tikai uz Daņsku, aizlido uz Daņsku stundu. Tur atpakaļ nospēlē spēle fantastiskā laukumā, fantastisks pretinieks, tur apkārt ir arka, tur ir pilns ar poļu klubiem, uz kuriem mēs varam uz Gdiņu lidot, spēlēt draudzības spēles, izlases pārtraukumos, fantastiski, man ļoti patika, es paldies ļoti apmierināts ar to visu, un es domāju, ka tas bija ļoti labs mums tāds gājiens, un iegūt to starptautisko pieredzi arī tādos apstākļos, domāju, ir svētīgi.
Jurģi Edmunds paprasīja par Kublu, varbūt nedaudz līdzīga stila jautājums. Es pagājušajā sezonā runājām par tomātiem, runājām par burkāniem un vēl visādiem virtuves piedarumiem. Vai ņemot vērā to, ka šodien lieldienas, vai tev vietējie iezemieši Jānis Gatis vai kāds cits no zinātājiem ir iemācījuši Valmieras salātu recepti?
Voilà! Pirmām kārtām iemācījuši viņu nav, bet es viņam varētu mēģināt iemācīt viņus, jo es viņus sākumā ļoti iemīlēju, teiksim, tā ieradoties Valmierā, bet tad man viņa kļūpa trek, nu, es pastījos spoguli, vienkārši sapratu, ka nevar vairāk, bet, nu, jo es neesmu no tiem, kas pats baigi grib sportot un pats baigi tur skrien un, kā teiksim, tā izmanto džimu, bet recepti man neviens nav iemācījis, diemžēl, bet, nu, es pat nezinu, ko lai tev atbildu, kādīgs tādi jautā.
Palīdzēšu, tad, kad skatīsies video skautīgu ap spēles 90. Minūti.
Pa Valmieras salātiem būs tāds.
Jā, var noskaidrot un ar sasitajām olām tikt galā tā kā paldies par spēli.
Jā.